Our Bible lesson for this morning is in Book of John, Gospel of John, chapters 15, verse 1 through 17. We're talking about committed to Christ. Today we're going to see one of the other aspects of our commitment to Christ. And this is Jesus talking about the true life. But we're not going to read the whole text. We're going to read just three verses, verse 5, verse 7 and verse 16. So John 15, 5, 7, and 16. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me you can do nothing. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. This is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Father, help us to understand your word. Bless us, O Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Wouldn't it be great if we had a way of knowing that we're really talking to God? Like a phone, and we could call him and be sure that he is there listening. I have good news for you. You don't need to wait that anymore. I have here the phone. Look at that. Well, you think that, well, it doesn't look good. Well, it's not the phone itself. It is what the phone can do. With this phone here, this is a special phone. You can call, dial, and talk to God. And let me tell you something. I have so many things. It has been a very tough beginning of the year, so I have so many things that I want to ask. And I found this all the way back in the office. And it's there all the time. I said, man, I couldn't talk to God. So I'm going to try, okay, hold on. I'm going to try it. And see the number. Yeah, hello? Yes. It's really you? God? You can see me? Sorry. I'm not thinking. I'm so surprised that this little phone here is working. I have so many things to ask you. And I'd like to pray, yes. I'd like to pray. Okay, yes, I'd like to talk to you. Hold on. It's right here. I wrote it. Yes. Okay. I'm ready. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. What? No? What? Yes, I'm reading right here. Oh, you thought that I want to talk to you. Yes, I want to talk to you. Is that prayer not good? Oh, it's good because Jesus taught us to pray that. Yes. Should I read? Oh, you want me to talk to you. Oh, to have a conversation. To tell you what I need. I got it. Well, yes. Yes, I'll do that. So I'm so glad that I can now use this phone. Yes, as you see, Yes, I got the right number. I'm so glad. Yes, JESUS. Yes, I got the number. Yes. And we're going to keep cocky. Yes, I'm glad, I'm glad. Can you believe that? It worked. It wouldn't be great that it worked. Wouldn't it be great that we could have something like that to talk to God? And sometimes we don't, our Christian life is a commitment to Christ, but the Bible says that that commitment to Christ involves prayer. Prayer is a conversation with Jesus, and we need to understand that. And Jesus here in these three verses, he is teaching the disciples very important lessons about prayer that I'd like to share with you. The first lesson that Jesus teaches the disciples about prayer is that prayer is recognizing and accepting our limitations. Recognizing and accepting our limitations. This is why we pray. And this is what Jesus says in verse 5. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. Apart from me, you can do nothing. We need prayer. And we need to pray. And we need prayer in our lives. Because we cannot do anything without Jesus. We cannot do anything without God in our lives. And this is very hard. And let me tell you something. It's hard for us men. I'm talking to you guys here. And for me, it's a little bit harder. Maybe I'm competing with Tony here, okay? For us, for me, the Latino man, macho man, I don't need anything and anybody to do anything for me because I can handle myself. No, really. I cannot. But it's so hard to accept that. It's so hard to realize that we are dependent. We depend. We need His help. Prayer is a humble experience because we go before the Lord with our needs and say, Lord, I cannot do it. Help me. Help me. I cannot handle this. I cannot solve this problem. I cannot take the next step. Help me. Help me. And we need to do that. You need to recognize and accept your limitations. And sometimes we need to ask someone to pray for us. Sometimes we're not praying right, we don't know how to pray. And sometimes we just need to say, hey brother, can you pray for me? I need help. Hey sister, can you pray for me? I need help. So let's do this. I'd like you to turn to one person to the other side of you and say this. I need help. Can you pray for me? Just that. Let's do it. Say it. The other side.
Can you pray for me?
Say it. Yes. I need help. It didn't hurt, did it? It didn't hurt. It didn't hurt. Now I want you to do something else. And if you're spread out, you need to get close to someone there. Because I want you right now to raise your voice and say, Lord, I cannot do it by myself. I need help. Can you say that? I'm going to repeat before you say it. Lord, I cannot do it by myself. I need your help. Let's do it together. Lord, I cannot do it by myself. I need your help. We need to memorize those words, to ask for prayer, and to come before the Lord and say, Lord, I need your help. So prayer is recognizing and accepting our limitations, but prayer is something else. Also, Jesus is saying that prayer is a conversation with someone who you know. Prayer is a conversation with someone who you know. Verse 7 says, if you abide in me, this is Jesus' part. If you abide in me, my words abide in you. Ask whatever you wish and it will be done. done for you. It's a relationship. It's a fellowship. We abide in Jesus. His words abide in us. We have a communication between the two of us. I talk to him. He talks to me. I obey. I live under his word. I'm guided by his word. And I receive his words, and then I talk to him back and ask what I need. I just say it. Sometimes words just kind of throwing words, prayers just throwing words in the air. And we hope that a genius will show up and give us the answers for what we need. Prayer is a relationship, it's a conversation with someone that we know. We know Jesus. We walk with him. We listen to him through his word. We pray through his word. And this is what Jesus said in the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew 6, 7. He said, "And when you are praying, do not use meaningless repetition as the Gentiles do. Or they suppose that they will be heard for their many words." Jesus is not interested in many repetitions, many words. Why? Because it's a conversation. I'm talking to him. I know him. He walks with me. And he talks to me. There's a hymn right there, right? There's a few words like that. It's a relationship. And we need to understand that it's a relationship. Prayer is a conversation with someone that you know. You know Jesus through his word. You obey, you walk with him, and then you talk to him. And he answers. But Jesus is interested because there's something else about prayer that he wants the disciples to know, and he wants you to know. And the third thing that he wants us to know about prayer is that prayer has its own rules. There are rules about prayer. And we need to learn those rules. If you don't know them, you're going to miss a lot of things. So let me share with you some of them. The first one, it is a conversation. It's because it is a conversation, there is a beginning, a middle, and the end. You know, you started, how you started. You talk about God, you go before him. You can use Heavenly Father, you can use Father, Almighty God. I don't know how you are in the presence of God. And then there is the conversation between what you need, what is your request, what you bring. You bring praise, you bring thanksgiving. You bring a need, a request, and then how you're going to end it. You need to learn that. There is rules for those things. And there are some traditions about prayer. And we need to understand that they are traditions. They are traditions. What does that mean about traditions? There are some things that we do when we say, "Let us pray." You do automatically. You fold your hands. You bow your head. You close your eyes. Automatically. You don't think. It's a reflex. It's a prayer reflex. You do that like that. They say, "Let us pray, everybody." It goes automatically. The neck already knows where to go. The eyes already know what to go. And they do it. But these are traditions. And those traditions are supposed to demonstrate something that is inside of you. We close our eyes because we don't want to be distracted. Why? Because we want to focus in God himself. We kneel or bow our heads because we recognize that we are in the presence of God Almighty. And he's powerful. So we kneel, bow our heads. That doesn't mean that you cannot open your eyes and pray. You can look at a beautiful flower, a tree, skyline, and a sunset. And you look at that and you praise God. It's okay. They are traditions, and you need to understand that. There are conditions, and they are stipulated by the Word of God. There are conditions on the Word. how our heart is prepared unto prayer, the humbleness, the attitude. How am I going to pray? I need to understand that I'm in the presence of God Almighty, and I'm talking to Him. And there are different kinds of prayer. This is why I gave it to you. There is the bulletin, the prayer hand from the Navigator. The Navigator, they have a lot of resources for Christian life. The prayer hand is right there inside of your bulletin. Keep that at hand. Put that in the refrigerator or nightstand, whatever you pray. We confess. There is confession, petition, intercession, thanksgiving, and praise. Five different types or kinds of prayer. Confess is when you agree with God about your sin. You agree with Him. Your word says that this is wrong. And yes, it's wrong. I'm sorry. Petition, when you ask God for your needs. You bring before God your needs. Intercession, when you pray for others. You bring their needs, not yours, their needs before God. Thanksgiving, when you thank God for what He has done for you. And praise, your voice, your wonder about God and who He is. And praise and touches all the other aspects of prayer, all the other kinds of prayer. You can use praise. But one thing that's very important for us to understand is there is only one way to go to God. It is through Christ Jesus. John 15:16 says, "You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask Him in my name." It is through Jesus. It is through His life, His sacrifice. God will not listen to me because I am the pastor. I have robbed and stole and all those kind of things. And I can say like that, my prayer. No, God is not going to listen because of that. God is not going to listen to me because I'm good. You know what? Because I'm not. God is going to listen to you and listen to me because of what Jesus did. I'm going to the Father through Jesus. In His name, I'm going to ask this. I'm not going to ask in my name, in the name of the church, in the name of the people. No. I'm going in the name of Jesus. It is Jesus that will take my prayer and bring before the Lord. And I need to understand that, and you need to understand that. So a successful prayer is through Christ, in His name that we pray. And we need to learn that. So now we're going to do an exercise. Are you ready? A prayer exercise. We're going to stand up if you can. Stand up. And you're going to turn to your neighbor. Just one pair. Now, if you don't have four people there, three is okay. Three is okay. And if you don't know the name of the person there, we have visitors today, so we're not going to push. We're going to say this. We're going to say this. Lord, bless this person in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, did you memorize that? Did you memorize that? Lord, bless this person in the name of Jesus. Amen. Okay, now turn to someone there and pray for that person. And then the other person pray for you. It's so simple. It doesn't work. You can add something if you want. But it's so simple. You can pray for someone. And you can be an instrument from God to bless someone. Someone right now is in need of a prayer, a blessing, a touch from God, a and you can be the instrument of that person. Isn't that great? So commitment to Christ involves prayer. Let us bow our heads and let us pray. Father, thank you for this beautiful instrument that you put in our hands, in our voices, in our hearts and minds. Pray for others. Help us to do that. Help us to come before you and bring not only praise and gratitude, but bring our requests and the requests of our brothers and sisters. Help us to bring our confession to you. Help us to serve you. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.